فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, imagine Allah giving us one after the other pieces of advice where He calls it wisdom, holistic wisdom, that which if you were to follow, you will achieve success of this world and the next. You will achieve the contentment that you so desperately need. Imagine Allah telling that to us. Well, He has. And this is in Surah Al-Isra. If you start from verse number 23 and you go on, you will find Allah giving you what is known as hikmah, the wisdom, what you need for your entire life. So today's session, we're going to concentrate on these points very briefly. With each point, you will see that if you were to adopt it, it will definitely bring about contentment and success in this world and the next. Let's look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, starting from verse number 23 of Surah Al-Isra.
وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا.
Allah has declared that you shall worship none other than Him, point number one. And you shall be kind to your parents, point number two, subhanAllah. You worship Allah alone because He made you. Nobody besides your Maker deserves any act of worship. Only your Maker, the one whom you're going to return to, deserves an act of worship or every act of worship. Secondly, He chose a means for you to come into existence, and that was your parents. Because Allah chose your parents, He wants you to be kind to them. He says, be kind to your parents. That was point number two. You see, the two are interconnected. So you worshipped Allah alone, you struck your relationship with Allah, you strengthened your relationship with Allah. Now start strengthening your relationship with those whom Allah chose to bring you into the world, your parents. May Allah make it easy for all of us to be good, kind and respectful to our parents. I've said it before and I'm saying it again. Respecting does not mean obedience. Obedience is only when it is not in the transgression of Allah and it is not usurping any of your rights. Then you obey. If it is usurping your rights and if it is in the transgression of Allah, you don't obey, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one whom we obey. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us success. Thereafter, Allah speaks about the parents and how when they grow older, you must pray for them. You must think about, if you want contentment, think about the sacrifices your parents made for you when you were a baby. When you grew older, your parents looked after you. Think about that. It will bring about contentment and you will look after them with a little bit more of happiness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that contentment that we so desperately need. Then Allah says, after that, you are related to certain people. We want you to look after them as well. Are you looking after your family members? Are you looking after your broader relatives? Do you reach out to them? Do you greet them? Do you talk to them? Do you interact with them even a little? And when they're in need, are you there for them? Or do you expect them to go further away? So Allah says, verse number 26,
وَآتِ ذَا الْقُرْبَى حَقَّهُ وَالْمِسْكِينَ وَابْنَ السَّبِيلِ وَلَا تُبَذِّرْ تَبْذِيرًا.
Many pieces of advice. Allah says, give your relatives their due. Give the masakin, and give masakin meaning the poor people, and give those who are wayfarers, those who are homeless perhaps, those who are travelers perhaps. They are called ibnus sabil. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't be wasteful. Don't be wasteful. Give others. Don't waste. When you have two of what you need one of, you are wasting. Remember that. I could have one very expensive car, but the minute I have two, three cheap cars and I'm not using them, I'm being wasteful. So to have a quality, a good quality of something is not necessarily waste if you can afford it. But to have two of what you need one of is a waste, even if it is cheap. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. I hope you understood what I just said. So my brothers and sisters, Allah says, don't be wasteful. Why?
إن المبذرين كانوا إخوان الشياطين وكان الشيطان لربه كفورا.
Indeed, the devil or those who are wasteful are brethren of Shaytan, and Shaytan is very ungrateful. So you become ungrateful. When you waste and you're extravagant, you become ungrateful regarding the favors of Allah upon you. And thereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't be miserly as well. Look at the balance. He says, don't waste because you become a brethren of the devil. And then he says, and don't be miserly. Spend in the middle. You need to know how to spend. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَا تَجْعَلْ يَدَكَ مَغْلُولَةً إِلَىٰ عُنُقِكَ وَلَا تَبَسُطُهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ.
Allah says, and don't keep your hand tied to your neck, which means don't hold back and don't release fully, but you rather seek a balanced path. If you release fully, you will regret. I gave even my necessity, I gave it away. Allah says, you don't have to do that. Don't give what you desperately need away to someone. But don't be miserly either. Learn to give and Allah will provide you more and more. So that is another point of balance. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ خَشْيَةَ إِمْلَاقُ نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُهُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ.
Don't kill your children fearing poverty. We will provide for them and for you. People used to kill their children, literally kill their children. May Allah safeguard us. Child is born, they say, I can't provide for the child. Kill the child. That is prohibited, totally prohibited. Don't not have kids fearing poverty. There are other reasons why a person may perhaps not want to have kids immediately after marriage. But when it comes to the issue of finance and money, Allah says, don't worry, I'll take care of all of that. If it is really a money matter, I will take care of it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, help us and provide for us and make it easy for us to provide for our children. Ameen. He has promised that. Don't worry. Sit back and relax. Remember, many times people cannot afford a life that they have in their minds and that they want to live. But they can afford a slightly downgraded life that is still comfortable, but perhaps not in line with the Joneses. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. Many of us are struggling, not because we don't have what we need, but because we don't have what we want. There is a very big difference. We lose contentment and happiness because we want things. It's not that we need them. So the minimum, Allah says, I'll provide for you. But you want much more than that. That's why you're upset. You want to prove to the neighbors and to everyone else that I have and I have and I have. My children go to these schools and my children will have this and I'll drive this car and I'll have this house. All that is cosmetic to show people. Don't live to show people. You will lose contentment. They will never be happy. You will not be happy. You will fight with your spouse because you can't afford things. Prioritize when it comes to your money and you will be the happiest person. Don't live to please others. They will never be happy. Learn to live within your means. If you have downgraded or you have to downgrade from a Mercedes to a Toyota, so be it. You will be the happiest person. If you have to downgrade from a Toyota to public transport, so be it. You will still be a happy person. But if you're too proud and your ego is stopping you from downgrading, don't blame anyone but yourself when you lose contentment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا.
Don't go close to adultery. Don't go close to it because you lose contentment. It will be very, very tough. If you have fallen, seek the forgiveness of Allah. He will forgive you. But don't go close to it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ.
Part of this verse, Allah says, don't commit murder. Don't kill people. Don't kill the ones whom Allah has prohibited you from killing. How can you take away the life that Allah has given in an unjust way? Unjustified. You're taking people's lives away. You're committing murder. Allah's reminding you that the giver of the life is Allah. Who gave you the right to take away life that was given by the same one who gave you your life? Oh, subhanallah, subhanallah. People use religion in order to take life away. For what? Allah is the giver of your life and that life. So both lives are equally sacred. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. Then he says,
وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا مَالَ الْيَتِيمِ.
Don't get close to the wealth of the orphans. Don't try and consume the wealth of orphans. Don't cheat them. Don't deceive them. Make sure that you understand that wealth is an amana. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says thereafter, وَأَوْفُوا بِالْعَهْدِ, and fulfill your promise. Fulfill the covenant. Be an honest person. Don't eat wealth of people, the widows, the orphans, the weak, the downtrodden, the beggars, whoever they may be. Don't steal. Don't deceive. You will not achieve contentment when you've earned through deception. When you've cheated people, it will come back to haunt you. It will never, ever allow you to be content and to be happy. Sort your matters out. Seek the forgiveness of Allah. Seek the forgiveness of those whom you've wronged, and you will find much goodness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَأَوْفُ الْكَيْلَ إِذَا كِلْتُمْ,
and when you weigh, weigh properly. What does that mean? When you're doing business, don't shortchange people. Amazing. In business, don't shortchange people. If you cheat in business and deceive in any way whatsoever, your wealth you might get, you won't be happy. No contentment. You cheated people. You earned through haram. Your food might have been slaughtered in the proper way, but it was not bought with proper money. So what do you expect? How can you get happiness? My brothers and sisters, don't deceive in business. It will never, ever bring about any goodness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says,
وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا.
Allah says, and don't pursue that which you have no knowledge about. When you follow, don't follow blindly. You need to have knowledge. Improve your knowledge. Increase it. Follow that which you have knowledge regarding. Allah says your hearing, your sight, your heart, your thoughts, all of that you will be questioned about. So try and purify yourself as best as you can. You'll be the happiest person. Purify your thoughts. Have clean thoughts. We are taught it's all about cleanliness. Half of our faith is cleanliness. You cleanse your acts of worship, you cleanse yourself physically, you cleanse your thoughts, the way you look, the way you walk, the way you talk, the way you do business. And everything else should be clean and it should be upright. Then you achieve contentment, otherwise you won't. At the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا.
Don't tread this earth with arrogance. Don't be arrogant. Not at all. Don't walk in a haughty way. Don't drive in a haughty way. Don't, you know, be in public in a way that you think you're bigger than everyone else and you're a big deal. You will lose contentment, Allah says. You will never be a happy person. You are just like everyone else. Be humble. Be filled with humility. You will be content. The minute your humility is gone, your ego creeps in, your pride comes in, you will lose that happiness and contentment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. He tells us, worship none but Allah, and you will achieve that contentment. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.
الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله, ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.